sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerge from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. A couple of 2-1 teams set to square off, and we're underway here in NFL Week 4. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Come out throwing here to start the drive. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. This is caught. It's Brown. The 30. 10. Touchdown, Jaguars. Marquise Brown, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. Taking it about the 1. And he's going to be brought down inside the 5 at the 3.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Mahomes now to throw. Now a swing pass. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30.
That turns into a very well-orchestrated play right there. Going to work his way out of the backfield to the right. And after he looked it in, he found plenty of space to roam and picked up big yardage.
They'll get that one out quickly to Brown. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So that as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football. All right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. With it is Brown. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football.
And that's what friends are for.
As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there. That's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
Now a throw here to his running back. 3 yards the gain there, second down. This defense for the Chiefs, they put together a strong effort last week in the win over Chicago.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball? Or maybe just one or two receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright?
And the pass is intercepted. He was looking for Ingram. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise.
And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. It's a big play there for the Chiefs. Mahomes gonna throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. Tyreek Hill. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. The extra point up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. He'll drop to throw. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Defensively, they came into the game with the understanding they're going to have to slow him down on passes just like this, because he was over 100 yards receiving a week ago. And you know they want to get him involved here as well.
With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
He's going to air one out. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. And this will set them up nicely deep down in KC territory. It's a big play for the Jaguars.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field, Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route, well run, and the football, right on the money.
He'll drop this one off with ETN. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. ETN, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. They'll try to run with ETN. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1. On is Josh Lambeau now for the Jaguar field goal. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. The kick by Lambeau is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this...
And the Jags get to him as down he goes. A loss of 4 that time on the sack, and it brings up 2nd.
You know darn well both of these teams reviewed the film and saw that this defense had 5 sacks last week. They got to keep their QB upright.
And they're going to try their best to do exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a mantra for them. And they play a game within the game. And you know what it is? Let's race to the quarterback and see who gets there first.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain. I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off. Not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down, makes it manageable now.
Now here's Mahomes. Catch is made by Hardman. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. They go play action. Now Mahomes. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Julian Blackman. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And it's now 17-14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
It's complete to Brown, right side. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
Time to give some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, be able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it.
Finding room to the 20, and he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line. The Chiefs with the football as we start the second quarter. An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports.
Mahomes throw complete here to his receiver Brown.
And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Now Mahomes, flush to his right. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away, and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes. And he's got Hardman in the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City. Mecole Hardman, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are going to jump back in front.
And now before we get to the extra point, remember all touchdowns do have to be confirmed by the replay official.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Taken from about the 12. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, might be...
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Juan Thornhill.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now... His head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down. They go play fake. Mahomes. Caught. Kelce, left side. And he'll be out of bounds.
And that's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you want to give him a little extra for the effort. But instead, he sets his guys up in excellent shape with a first and goal.
Edwards-Helaire will take this one in. It's a Chiefs touchdown.
Well, nothing fancy there, Charles. You had 3 tight ends on the field. They were going to run the football. The defense knew it, but the defense couldn't stop them.
And I haven't met an offensive line yet that doesn't get more satisfaction out of running the football into the end zone than pass protecting. They had determination on their side, and they got it done.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
pulls it in at the 13. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. That catch good for only a couple. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. They'll set up to throw. Flushed out right. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Delano Hill. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case,
touchdown! Travis Kelce, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is up to 18 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
Pulls it in at the 13.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off near the 26. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
And now the drive starts with a completion out to the right. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
On second and inches, Mahomes. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. Travis Kelce with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chiefs are able to widen their lead here in this first half. The extra point up and good. And a route is on here in this first half. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
taken from about the 12.
And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Second and 10.
He'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And this will set them up nicely deep down in KC territory. It's a big play for the Jaguars.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. Touchdown, Jaguars! Evan Engram, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars get a score closer. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And that'll cut the lead down to 18. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And a mistake, a surprising mistake there in the kicking game as he sends that one out of bounds. The Chiefs in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Edwards-Helaire on the counter. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
44 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point.
Right back to Edwards-Helaire on first down. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. 7 yards there and a first down.
And this is just a little touch pass. They send the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward to him. That doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice consistent gain.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes, eluding the pressure right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. The corner blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
to dig out of here. Second and 17.
Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes, and that is incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 17. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. This is caught, and they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. They'll try to run with Edwards-Helaire. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Second down and goal. Mahomes. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Travis Kelce. On his way to a monster game, 3 first half touchdowns. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead. The point after is good. And a rout is on here in this first half. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Pulls it in at the 13. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Here's 2nd and 10. Now back to throw. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw here. And now here is another interception. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown 6 interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it 3 times.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a 1st and goal.
Flush to his right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score 1 touchdown,
You want 2.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got 1, but was denied as he tried to get the 2nd one.
Now, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal. They will try to run with Edwards-Helaire. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Clyde Edwards-Helaire as the first half is winding down. And the Chiefs will extend their lead here just before halftime. Point after up and good. And a rout is on here in this first half. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken from about the 12. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive as they go to work with 12 seconds on the clock. They're spinning away. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times, you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop it behind the line. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three.
Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. This is taken just shy of the 10. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
And it's hard to imagine that the first half could have gone any better for them. So what's the approach here in the second half?
Just continue to play smart football because they got the other team down and they feel good about the position they're in. The obvious thing people would say is just keep attacking, but I think you also have to be smart about it. Avoid turnovers. That's about the only thing that can derail you at this point. Attack, but make sure you take care of the ball.
Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down in the backfield. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And if anyone thinks they're just going to tuck their horns in and pull back off the throttle a little bit, you can forget it. Even with this big third quarter lead, I think this team's going to continue to take their shots downfield, and there's another completion.
Play clock down to 2, and we get a signal and a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. 1st and 10.
And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
2nd down, back to Edwards-Helaire. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sip through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Throwing is Mahomes on 3rd. Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. It's Brown.
And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. So 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
Now Edwards-Helaire.
And he is close to a first down as he's tackled at the Jaguars 31. 71 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Mahomes now to throw. A quick slant to Hill. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. Second down, back to Edwards-Helaire. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
Complete the tight end, Kelsey. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up 1st and 10. A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score 56. Jaguars 24.
2nd down, back to Edwards-Helaire. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. The Chiefs on 3rd down. They've been flat getting it done, 8 for 9 to this point. This is 3rd and 11. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. He's able to chew up 8 yards on the carry there, but still, 4th down upcoming. Now the Chiefs spring on their field goal unit. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that will just add 3 more to a lead that's already out of hand.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They'll start on the ground, ETN. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame wolfing has turned into results.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. So from 2nd and long, now we go to 3rd and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in 4-down territory, that really opens things up for you.
And he's got his man, Marquise Brown. And he will have a Jaguars 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They'd go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. Another tote for ETN. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
And this will be incomplete. Boy, can you believe this? That one probably should have been picked, too. Instead, it's fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46.
And yes, everyone, that was the fullback carrying the football. I know it's a dying breed, it's a dying position for a lot of people, but I still think it's valuable and important, especially one who can carry the ball.
And you need short yardage. What makes sense? Go to a big body, let him plow forward just like he did there.
It's still a big man's game.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. And they'll go again with ETN. And this play is going nowhere as he dives to the ground behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. And they're looking at a third straight win here if they can hold on. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Working from the gun, Mahomes. And that is incomplete.
I don't know. He had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
The mental focus.
Yeah, that's true.
You got to stay with it.
That's true.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
On first and 10, it's ETN.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. One final shot. They'll look to throw.
They'll try and set up the screen to ETN.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Chiefs, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Mile High to take on the Broncos. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Nashville.
Thank you.